Hi, welcome back to the Gun Viking channel. Today I'm making a little unboxing video. The other day I got a message from the post office that there was a couple of packages waiting for me. I jumped in the car, drove down and picked them up. And yes, behold, they was from the gun shop. Inside one of them I found a little black box, and on the box it says Ruger. And it is my Ruger 2245 Lite. When I open the box, I find a blue paper slip from the police. You won't find that one in the US, but here in Norway, you have to register every gun. You also find a user manual. They're pretty good from Ruger, actually. And you find some papers with a recall notice. And some NRA adverts. There are a lot of discussions about the NRAs these days. And the sticker. I usually put them on the gun safe. And some assorted papers, where you can get some discount if you buy from Ruger. And it comes with an extra magazine and a gun lock. And you also find some parts for removing the right side safety. And of course, the Ruger Mark IV 2245 Lite. I bought it in gold because I'm gonna shoot for gold. The Mark IV is the latest model from Ruger. The biggest disadvantage of the Ruger 22 rimfire pistols has always been cleaning and disassemble. But this one is fixed with the Mark IV. It's very easy to disassemble and very easy to clean. We're gonna see that later in the video. The muzzle comes threaded in 1/2" by 28", which is very practical because most of the moderators, or silencers or whatever you call it, and compensators are threaded in 1/2" by 28". Right away I had to see how it looked with a suppressor on it, and I tested it with my attatch Wave, which is a Norwegian made suppressor. It's a very high quality suppressor, I can highly recommend it. And the gun looks really nice with it. It almost had no weight. Well, we take it off. The case has room for some ammunition or cleaning equipment. Let's take it apart and see how easy it is. Be sure to cock the hammer and put on the safety. And this is all you have to do to disassemble it. I'm just gonna clean the gun real quick to make it ready for the range. And I also use quite a lot of oil when I clean my guns, because I like to run them quite wet. One time I heard about a guy that is quite known in the shooting community talk about how wet he runs his guns, and he just said, when I pick it up, it marks territory. I just have to point out one thing, and that is the trigger. Everything else on the gun is great, but the trigger is just, well, horrible. I might be a little bit spoiled by usually shooting Hemleys and tuned Browning Buckmarks, but this trigger is real bad. So I guess every aftermarket maker of triggers just love this gun. Unfortunately, aftermarket triggers in Norway is quite expensive, so I just have to save up some money before I order one. Now let's get to the range. I can't wait to shoot this gun. I had to try it with a suppressor first, and it worked great. It's just lovely to shoot without earmuffs. The first 50 shots have been shot, and it works great. I've used it only with suppressor. I'm gonna take it off afterwards and see if it works great without suppressor. No problem. Works great. I'm really struggling with double taps. The trigger makes it really difficult. Maybe I just have to sell a kidney and buy the trigger right away.